Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac, Victa Repentance series. Woo, we got a little bit exciting yesterday, huh? Yeah, Maw of the Void's one of those items that gets me into trouble just because I love using it. And again, as I said in yesterday's episode, you know, it's just one of those items that, like, I just feel like I have to. If I've got it, I got to use it. And sometimes it works out. Sometimes you get a little bit hairy. So thank you very much for all the support, everyone. Hope your Fridays have gone off to a great start here in the Mosh Pit. We're starting off this one right here with a good meme of the day brought to you by Sponge Dice. Title thread was still better than Spirit Airlines. Come fly with us at Full Clear Airlines. It's mathematically impossible. Yeah. We've had a variant, actually a couple variants of this of the Full Clear Airlines before, but this one was a new template that I haven't seen before. So thank you very much, Spun Dice, and everyone who upvoted that one. 23,000 members of the Mosh Pit going strong on the subreddit. Seed Day is going to be Papa 9 Zulu 4 November, Victor Mike Zulu. We've got just god-awful tears rate, but that's okay because we're starting off with the Spirit Sword. And also the pinking shears, which honestly, like, I'm okay with. I'm okay with this. We also get Proptosis, which is going to massively increase our damage that we deal point blank, because obviously, well, Spirit Sword is point blank. And yeah, you talk about items that you feel like you have to use. Well, this one is one that you literally have to use. I'm going to go ahead and use pinking shears here, so they give us flying, just to make it a little bit easier for us to get around in this room. But wow, what a freaking start here for Friday. I'll definitely take it. So the pinking shears are going to give us flying for the room, and also have, of course, that torso that falls around and deals damage every now and then. It deals good damage to everything that it finds and that it could possibly hit. Since we have a golden bomb here, there's no excuse for us not to find the secret room and super secret room. I'm extremely upset that we took damage in there, because that's the only way that we could have possibly done that, is if one of the bombs had purposely, deliberately waited until exploding. So there's that. So we got to be a little bit careful here with only one HP now. I'm gonna blow up the keeper and not myself, because that would be kind of suboptimal, I'd say. Yeah, yesterday's run definitely it got a little shaky, I would say. Light it over. This is not a good matchup for us, actually. But thankfully, we do have the pinking shears, so at least the pinking shears will be able to stay on Blighted Oven for a while. I don't even think we honestly even bother with the Spirit Sword. We got to be really, really cautious whenever you have that little champion over there. One key. I'm not going to go look for coins. We do need some HP, though. So now the big problem is that we have no key. We have no bombs anymore on this floor. So we've got to be, you know, if we do find a tinted rock, you know, maybe hopefully there's a soul heart in there, which we just found a tinted rock, speaking of. But unfortunately, we don't have any way of actually blowing up the rock. We have a way to get to it, but no way of actually getting and destroying the rock in general. So, you know, hopefully we're able to find a bomb, and then obviously there's stuff in there as well. Now, Rock in a Jar will give us 5 bombs, but I don't like it, because there are times when, like, there are times whenever I have actually, like, fired Rock in a Jar and hit myself. And we cannot afford that on 1 HP. And to be honest, like, it's not even worth using for me anyway, even if I have full HP, unless I have Pyromaniac or something, or we have a lot of really good bomb synergies. I'm just not generally interested in it. I think I'm just chopping up the dips here. I'm not going to take any chances with the orange fires. I don't want to give them a chance to actually blow up on us. Not blow up on us, but shoot us. It found soul. The found soul will basically follow it. It's basically it's kind of like he's kind of like a discount incubus in a way. Like he'll do everything that you want. He'll copy everything that you do, and you know, it's nice to have if you have the right tier effects and that sort of thing. But he does die, much like Lost Soul Buddy. He does die in one hit, and he's very fragile. So unlike Incubus, like, you know, he's not quite reliable. And as luck would have it, we have no bombs in here. And of course, we buy a 7-cent sack and get 2 cents out of it. So that's really good. So I think what we're going to do is just get my money back for that. And our key, of course. All right. 0 soul hearts, 0 bombs. Now, we could also, of course, buy the glowing hourglass, but I think that that's... On 1 HP, it's not going to matter if we take damage, really. And we shouldn't have any problems with any bosses that you just clearly see right there. It's just, it's a matter of getting the HP, and we are still not getting that. Get blind rage. We can't take a devil deal. Maybe we can if there's like 9 lives or something in there, but an angel deal would make more sense. Yeah, we have enough offense here. We don't need a devil deal. I'm going to pass on it. So now, the big question. Should we have gotten Rocket in a jar? Because obviously that was the only source of bombs. We could have gotten a soul heart. It's, again, it's debatable. Yes, we would have gotten 5 bombs, and yes, you can activate the bombs without actually activating the rockets. You just have to make sure that you're not firing while you're placing them. And it's something that you can, that is very easy to forget, or at least for me to forget. I actually didn't need to even lay that bomb. I think I may have been able to reach that key with the spirit sword. But it's not something, I'm willing to take a risk on while only having 1 HP. The spirit sword also in almost every sense of the word, a double-edged sword. How in the world were they expecting us to actually hit these mobs if we didn't have Lost Soul Buddy? Because they are definitively out of range. I guess we'd have to use the Master Sword range attack. Anyway. Charm of the Vampire, it is a damage up, but obviously, again, doesn't give us any help on the HP department. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm a little bit concerned. You know, with the spirit sword, as I was talking about, is a double-edged sword in the very literal sense, because we have to get so close and personal. And this, you know, the situation that we find ourselves in on this run, it very, very eerily kind of mimics what we were talking about yesterday with Maw of the Void. You know, but in this sense, like, we are actually, like, we legit have to use it. So, like, this is kind of, like, a little bit even more dangerous in a way that, you know, we are forced to use this. We're not forced to use Maw of the Void. We have to use spirit sword. So doubles our bombs. We'll definitely take that. So unfortunately, it's one floor too late. But ooh, the D in fizzle. Oh baby, now what do we do? Well, we have 1 HP. That's about as perfect as a reroll can get out of the D Infinity. So, do we go 9? I mean, 9 lives makes a lot of sense in our current predicament here. If we get a soul heart, I would feel a little bit more gambly. We also have to kind of figure out what we're going to get from this angel deal, if we do get an angel deal at that. Because, you know, if it's HP that we're looking for, there's many different ways to get HP. We can get the body, we can get magic mush, we can get, you know, we can get the soul. There's lots of different things. We have to take this, so. Go ahead and bomb the keeper here just so we get a little bit of extra chance to get an angel deal. Something else that we could possibly consider would be something like Holy Mantle. But, I mean, with Death Certificate, we have the choice of anything in the game. Anything. You know, we could go, if we wanted to, we could go Rock Bottom. And there's so many choices early on, you know. See here, damage is not a problem, and we just get Tropicamide, which It doesn't help us here. Okay, so we need to be careful we don't actually swing at anything. So there's Magic Mush. Magic Mush is one possibility. Should get soul. There should be plenty of soul hearts in here for us to get as well. That is another nice little perk about Death Certificate. Sin Robes obviously gives us more soul hearts as well. I don't think we want to use the Hermit Garden here. Black Candle gives us a soul heart. And Crown of Light. Heck X is also very intriguing. I don't think Lost Soul would pick stuff up if he runs into him. Eden's Blessing. So I'm not playing coy here. I don't actually have anything in mind that I can think of that I would want. Sacred Heart feels like the right one to go because obviously we have enough HP now to where we're out of the danger zone, and Sacred Heart would boost our damage just incredibly. The epic proportions. Rock Bottom doesn't really have any sort of... It doesn't give us any sort of help right now. But there is another item that does give us a... does give us help. It's not Sissy, even though I'd love to. I think some of you might be onto what I'm... You might be buying what I'm selling here. If we take Binge Eater solves all of the problems. But it's one of those contentious items that I am guilty of making contentious, I suppose. Because, you know, it does make for very one-dimensional runs. C-section is also not a bad idea. C-section with a Spirit Sword is not terrible. We go for Spin Down Die. Spin Down Die is also a possibility. This is tough. This is legit tough. Binge Eater makes the most sense. I didn't even see Sacred Heart. I'm not gonna take Binge Eater. I'm gonna go C-section. But Binge Eater would have been my play. I also forgot to go back and get the D-Invisal. That's okay. So, we've got Sacred Orb, or not Sacred Orb, Spirit Sword, C-section, thanks to Death Certificate. Now, why did I not take Binge Eater? Well, Binge Eater is just a done deal. There's very little in terms of like guesswork as far as like what's going to happen on a Binge Eater run. And I mean, this one's also probably pretty much wrapped up. But at least with C-section Spirit Sword, it's not a combo you get to see all the time, and it is fun to see. And on top of that, we're out of the danger zone for now anyway. So this, and it is a viable combo. I have had Spirit Sword C-section before. It's been a while, but it's a very, very powerful combo, a very sick combo as well to look at. It's just neat to play as, really. But ultimately, if you were in my position and in that scenario and you were like, Zinvicta, I need your recommendation on like what I should pick, it would be Binge Eater. It is hard for me to not recommend Binge Eater in most situations if you get Death Certificate, just because of how good it is. Now, I know that's not the sexy choice, but it is strong. I mean, we've seen what happens when we get Binge Eater on pretty much every single item pedestal. It is that good. You know, Rock Bottom, I've said it before, and I'll keep saying it. I don't think it's an automatic pickup for me in the Death Certificate scenario. I think that rock bottom, if you already have the existing synergies, or if you already have, if it's at the beginning of a run, like it's not going to be a bad thing. But I will say that, you know, rock bottom is highly dependent on you getting stuff that is also going to be canceled out by its bad sides. So, you know, you really don't get value out of there until after you've either after you've already taken bad items that have downsides, or, you know, if you get lucky and get like soy milk or something like that. So the most obvious choice for me is Ben Jeter in that spot. That's where I'll leave that discussion. But looking forward, we've got C-Section, we've got Spirit Sword. They're chopping things up. They're doing all kinds of good stuff. And we just missed another 68% deal with the Angel. Womp, 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 womp. I feel like this week has been rife with high percentage failures. Lots of, I mean, what feels like lots and lots and lots of 73 percenters, 68 percenters of us just whipping. I don't know if it's like the lowest percentage that we've gotten in terms of like high, like what should have been successful angel deals or devil deals this week. I don't know what the record is, but it feels like we've seen a lot of them this week. Lots of floor five. We even had a floor six deal with the angel, so that was fun. Two of hearts. Well, we might as well just go fight now. It's gonna be Gish. Gish is gonna give us absolutely bloody nothing. Our Bethlehem is acceptable. Take the key piece number two. All right, let's go back and find the item room real quick, which I'd imagine is going to be very close over here. Very happy that we got Roid Rage, by the way. Gives us a nice movement speed upgrade. Sad bombs, you know, it gives us bombs. Unfortunately, they don't turn into C-section babies. That'd be really cool. Now, what would this run have looked like had we actually held on to the D and Fizzle? Well, probably a lot different, because I would have re-rolled Ogish, and I probably would have re-rolled Sad Bombs as well. I don't know if I would have re-rolled Star Bethlehem. Star Bethlehem is pretty good. And yeah, there we go. We're doing the reverse all clear here. Got 9 bombs. I'm going to be super lazy. Okay, that would be there. Apparently not. It's absolutely worth the 2 bombs here for 1 soul heart. And a key and a coin. Definitely need a tiers upgrade, though. That's the one problem that I have with C-section is that it does massively reduce the amount of tiers that you're able to fire out. So, and yeah, it's another case of the real life coming to the meme. We have ourselves a all clear here. Yep. After finding the boss immediately, we do a full clear to get Kamikaze. All right. Not even worth picking up, Isaac. Although we did have an Isaac Madness run on Wednesday. Yeah, Wednesday. It was our first Isaac Madness run that we did this week. Which, by the way, if you've been missing it, we've been doing one Isaac Madness run so far. One at least. Per stream this week so far on the Twitch channel, so definitely come check them out. They're a lot of fun. Even if you don't take part in it, it's still a fantastic way to see just how crazy Isaac can get and how devious the mosh pit can be. Yeah. All right, Star Bethlehem, show us the way. Trying to tap my phone there to see what time it was. and accidentally hit the escape key. Or not the escape key, but the tilde key. There we go. This is what we can expect. This is what we can expect with a high tears rate, which we don't have right now. I don't know if I've been meaning to tell you that or not, but... Star of Bethlehem. The star is showing us that this is the way. Just have our flying swinging babies everywhere. Definitely making up a lot of good time here for boss rush. We're gonna be firing three babies at once now, which normally I would say be real careful with your tears rate here, but our tears rate is already so bad when it comes to C-section that lowering it a little bit more is not gonna make a difference, especially considering that you get triple the amount of babies. So it's definitely worth it to get multi shots on C-section for sure. And yes, you know, obviously your tears rate goes right down the crapper, but you get the added benefit of just an insane amount of extra DPS, especially when you're talking about C-section Spirit Sword. And this is not a run where I even have to question about doing boss rush here, because we can very easily handle boss rush. I mean, very easily. So I'm not even going to look for a fool card if it's worth it. If boss rush is worth it. Which it is not. All right, Bethlehem, send us home. You hear Charm of the Vampire going off there. I'm not going to use the Soul Blue Baby. I think that would be a very bad idea. We could sort of hover around the babies as well while they're swinging. You know, they're not going to act as orbitals, obviously, but anything that's dumb enough to get close to us while we're, like, surrounded by our pack of babies is going to be dead before they even know what hit them. Yes, I unironically used the term pack of babies to describe what's happening on your screen right now. So, cheers to that. Things you can only hear in Isaac without sounding like a complete psychopath. Not sure if I would want a pack of babies anywhere near me. I've been surrounded by parents with babies, and that's an interesting experience as someone who is not a parent. Not saying it's a good experience. I'm not saying it's a bad experience. I'm just saying it's one that, you know, it'd be like the equivalent of like being only a dog owner and then going to someone who owns nothing but birds. Like you went to a bird lovers convention. You know, it's kind of like, oh, okay, I feel a little out of place. Like, oh, it's squawking. It's cute. Oh, what's its name? Oh, yeah. I can tell. I see where it gets its name from. Yeah, Pooper. Someone's laughing out there. And that would be another high percentage failure. That was a 73%er that time. Woo! So that might be a record low for the amount of deals in one run. We've only seen two up to this point. We haven't taken any red heart damage. That is just Invicta luck at its worst right there. At its absolute worst. We are on floor... what is this? This is floor 8. Floor 8, and we have seen... two. That's almost laughably bad. If it were anyone else that you were watching, you'd be like, wow, that's horrible. But since you know about Sinvicta luck, it's like, oh, that's about on par. I mean, now, obviously, this is not the first run that we've gotten blanked like this before, but it definitely is the first run in a while. Just imagine if we had Something like kidney stone or... Oh, wow, we're going this way. Okay. I would have gone the other way. Shows you what I know, Star Bethlehem. Let's see if the wait was worth it here for our second angel deal of the run. No. The answer is no. Not even close. I'll take Monstrance because I think Guardian Angel is actually not very good. I'll take the key piece. Grab my key because, I mean, we might as well. Take Perfection. We could go fight Old Hushy, but I think that we're... No, we can go fight Old Hushy. That's fine. We're going to lose Perfection for sure, but at least we'll get some extra items, hopefully. Unfortunately, Star Bethlehem is not going to move for this entire floor, so... Which I think, honestly, that should be considered a bug. I think if you have Star Bethlehem, it should go to the boss room no matter who you're fighting, including Mega Satan. Like, if you zone in the room, it should follow you in there, but I digress. Bag of crafting. Maybe I'll take it just because it's better than a little portal. Okay. Unfortunately, we don't have the Star of Bethlehem in here. Yeah, your soul and Perfection are both done here. I'll be shocked if we come away without getting hit. Although I will say, I forgot that the Spirit Sword Whirlwind attack with C-section, they do actually block shots with them. Hush is going insane. I don't know why he's spawning so many ads. I don't think I've ever seen him spawn that many ads in the span of such a short amount of time. Down goes Old Hushy. Alright, bag of crafting, give us something good. They saw how important it was to have your soul as well for the extra babies. So keeping him alive is going to be pretty important. You were lucky I got out of there safe and sound there, your soul. Go back and craft up that heart. Safety pin, sure. It depends. Gonna give us some shot speed here. I'd like to get some tears right if possible out of the bag of crafting. Did Lost Soul Buddy just take that key? Also, buddy, we're going to have to talk. If you're using the bag of crafting the same time that I am, we're going to have some problems. Because I'm pretty sure that you just took that key. Waiting for the Star of Bethlehem to catch up here. Oh, God, Stanley, yep. Yeah, you push Satan into a corner like that, he's going to push back. There we go. Down goes Stanley. We even beat the Star of Bethlehem, surprisingly. Really hoping we find a Tears Up or something in here. Fear of the Night, Dark Arts. I mean, that is damage. I'm going to take Spirit of the Night only because it gives us 2 or 3 for Leviathan. And I also really, really want the flying. Of course, leave it to Mega Fatty to kill Lost Soul Buddy. So now we are basically forced to stick with the Star of Bethlehem. This looks like it's just a straightaway down here. I'd say on the whole, C-section, you know, it probably didn't really pan out. I was hoping that we were going to get more synergies than this, but we haven't gotten any. which is usually how it ends up shaping out to be for me. But that's not to say on the victory lap we can't get something a little bit juicier. I mean, Spirit Sword C-section is great. Don't get me wrong. I would have loved to be able to have a higher tears rate. Something like soy milk would be really, really nice with this. That lamb's just going to get mauled here. Going to turn him into a kind of Mediterranean dish. Here we go. Second run, Lima Lima Bravo 1 Zulu Kilo 7-8. All right, so here's the plan, Lost Soul, or Found Soul, or Lost Soul Buddy. Look, you're Lost Soul Buddy, all right? You're just the more useful Lost Soul Buddy. I need you to stick by me, okay? And another thing I need you to do is I need you to not use the Bag of Crafting when I do. Peach, I require the Bag of Crafting in its entirety to be used here for me. Where did that justice card go? I see you using it over there, Lost Soul Buddy. Yeah, you stay there. By the way, if you don't know how I'm doing that, making Lost Soul Buddy stick to one area, you just hold control. It's just like with Jacob and Yeehaw. You hold control. I have no idea what the key is on controller, but you just hold control. It's whatever the key is that you use to drop stuff. That it's the same button on the controller. Whatever button that is for you. That is what I use to pause Lost Soul Buddy. Parting Baby is certainly a thing. It certainly is a thing. Just babies galore here. There goes Monstro. I will take meat just because it gives us some kind of damage. Although Sty is not terrible. This gives us options. I don't really want options, to be honest. Like, we already have. I mean, we already have options. We literally just picked it up, so I think we'll wait. We can get something better. Unless the Bag of Crafting doesn't allow you to use, you may not be able to overwrite stuff in there. Oh, it's the other options. Okay. It's the options. Not more options, not theirs options, just options. Totally forgot that I had flying. go back and check out the item room real fast. Secret room should be there. Okay. Ammo undies. I will take the soul heart. You know what? I'm going to be honest. I'm not feeling bad at crafting. The dang thing just takes way too long. It's the whole reason why I don't like Tainted Cane. Finally get a Tears up here in Pisces. And we get a 5-room. I was kind of hoping for a 5-room. Okay, so we get a chance to do this 4 again. Can't go in the secret room. Forgot. Okay. You know what? Fine. I don't know why nothing happened there, but sure. Another Tears up here in Squeezy. That's what I'm looking for. Sack Dagger. Sack Dagger making a little bit of a comeback now. I like it. So the 5-room is going to be a forget-me-now, which will allow us to just do the floor again. And it gets extra items, which I'm all for. So hopefully we get a couple more tiers upgrades. That'll be nice. Check out the vault. Oh, yeah. So the portable slot, that's one of the few static recipes that exist in the bag of crafting now. Mega Bean. I mean, it's better than bag of crafting right now, so sure. We do have Gigante Bean as well, so I mean, we're gonna do some serious toots, y'all. I mean, get a load of this. Good lord. That was even bigger than I was expecting. Gonna take Nun's Habit here. No keys, unfortunately. We will have Mega Bean ready to go for the boss. This should be interesting. Wow. Oh my god. Abba dabba ding dong, gonna give us movement speed and damage. We do get Leviathan. Sure, we'll take a little horn as well. All right, see, now we're getting somewhere. Now we can say that we'll take an Emperor card. Gonna take the tiers up here with blue cap. Remember, we do have Pisces, so that does break the tiers cap as well. Now we're getting to somewhere respectable in terms of our tiers rate. Probably should have looked to see where Star Bethlehem went. I have no idea where it went. Not this way, I can tell you that. No, it probably went south. Oh, I was trying to pick up M. Oh no, lost soul, buddy. I think lost soul, buddy was also using the Mega Bean when we were, so I think. Maybe that's where the extra damage came from. Hey, boom, I think it was 10 bombs. And this is not the right way to go. Range up. We don't really need range. We'll take both of these. Cammy Conception, Duality. Cammy Conception is going to give us a a possible spawn for a deal with the devil. Familiar, like Incubus, Succubus, Dark Bum, Demon Baby. It's one of those. I can't tell if Lost Soul is actually using it or not. I think that was an Emperor card back there. Okay, let's take a look in this next room. Let's see if he does it. Yep, he definitely does. That is pretty cool. He's just the cooler, better Lost Soul buddy. Portable slot again, and member card. On a blind floor, a 35-cent half-price item. This has to be huge. And it's not. It's the I agreed. It's horrible. All right. I don't even think that it even works with C-section, but I can pretend like it does. Treatment. We didn't lose any tears. That's the biggest thing. We did gain HP too. And we're only one away from Spun now, which is nice. We're at a 90%. Now, if we fail this one, I mean, would you be surprised? Probably not, right? I remember we have flying. We have flying. We have double flying. We have Spirit of the Night and Leviathan, which one led into the other. Oh, I did hear the I agreed go off. So apparently it does work with C-section, which is news to me. There's our conjoined. Or no, it's not. I didn't take a ghost baby. That's right. We'll get multi-dimensional baby, which is going to be... I don't think multi-dimensional baby works with C-section. Yeah, it doesn't. It only shoots out the tears. That is one good member shop. Let me tell you something, brother. Wow, that is an impressive amount of damage from Mega Bean. Yeah, we'll take safety pin for a little bit of shot speed. D-Bizzle. Yeah, let's go ahead and finish off conjoined. There you go, D-Bizzle. See what kind of mood you're in today. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, son. I mean, it's Friday. We got to have a good run. You knew it was going to be good as soon as you saw the thumbnail. We're loving it. So now we have conjoined, which is actually incredible with C-section, especially with C-section inner eye, because this is just more babies that we're firing out. So that's just more damage. That's just more swords, more everything. I don't know if this is the right way. This feels like the right way. It is. E-Wizzle. Nah. Eh. Oh, we're out of keys. Ember's Machine. Oops. Didn't mean it. I'm sorry. Sorry, Lost Soul Buddy. I really didn't mean it. We get a key here, so we can probably end up running into one of the locks that we don't need to open, just because that's just how it goes. That's just how it be, you know? And I think that we should go into the item room. You don't really have enough money to make the shop worthwhile. Oh, man. Varicose veins. Varicose veins is going to be an interesting one. And I think it's time to go see old Beastie. We haven't seen Beastie in a while. Let's go get my Emperor card real quick so I don't forget it this time. Go see old Beastie. Now, unfortunately, we will not have the Star of Bethlehem for the Beast fight. But we will have it for Dogma, though, I believe. I should be letting D-Bizzle grab these on D-Bizzle. Yeah, buddy. See, it's a Friday. He knows. He's feeling it. All right. He already got the partying out of the way during the week, and he's ready for game time. This is game time. Sunday is here. Well, not yet, but it's almost here. Yeah, we don't have enough money to go to the store, so I mean we do, but we don't. We get to see what our blind item is on the way out. The ascent here. Obviously, we're not going to get to have any benefit of Star of Bethlehem because we are not going to the boss room. We're going in reverse. That's the reason why you won't see Star of Bethlehem here. And we don't have a key. And we still don't have a key. All right. Never mind. We won't get to see what's inside of the boss room. And by boss room, I mean the item room. Can we even go in Delirium from here? There you go. Now, I know that we skipped at least one other item room. It wasn't this floor, but it was like floor 3 or something like that. Or floor 4. It was one of the cave floors because we had Curse of the Blind. I do like that all the C-section babies are canceling out a lot of the death rattle tears as well. This one, and it was Lost Soul, buddy. It's the actual Lost Soul. All right, that's just awesome. I think he's already dead. That's super great. Thanks, Lost Soul, buddy. He lived. Let's see what he gives us. This is one of the times where if you are going for Beast, Lost Soul is actually quite good. Lost Soul, buddy. If you can keep him alive, that is, because it's like if you're going for like an unlock or an achievement or something like that, then Lost Soul is super clutch because he can give you a bunch of HP on the way up if that's something that you needed. Now, obviously, we need HP, but we don't need Red Heart HP. So, you know, thank you, Lost Soul, buddy. Appreciate it. And up we go. I don't think Dogma is going to really have too much of a fun time here. Three extra soul hearts here because of the bed. Remember, if you don't have any red heart containers, you can just simply touch the bed, and that is your soul hearts on lock, as the kids would say. I don't think the kids say that. Ooh, one final damage upgrade here. And a soul of Eve. You know what? I don't know if we can use it against old Beastie, but we're gonna give it our shot here, Isaac. Oh no, Lost Soul, buddy. Oh no. Look at that C-section just going ham here on... Oh my gosh. Going ham on all the deflections. Dogma's just getting mauled. Down goes Dogma. Yeah, that worked out about as well as I thought it would. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this very, very fun run. Definitely check out the seed if you want to have some fun with Death Certificate. And let me know in the comments down below, did you do the same thing that I did? Did you pick C-section? Did you go for Binge Eater? Do you think this run would have been better with Binge Eater? Let me know. Like I said, I would love to know. your thoughts and comments down below. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button as well as the best way to support my channel. Leaving a comment and doing so is even better than that. Use Gigante Bean. Not sure why Pestilence is all the way down there, but you know what? He's living his own life. He's having a ball. He's having several. And you see here, unfortunately, we don't get the Star of Bethlehem inside of this room. It would be nice if we did. One of those situations where I do think that Star of Bethlehem should follow you into the fight. But, I mean, the item already does so much already. So, you know, it's... I don't know if it's intended like that, but I definitely would love to see it come out and be useful in other fights. But what a run, man. What a run. What can you expect? We got Spirit Sword. We started with Spirit Sword. Getting C-section, having a death certificate appearance. It's always a good time. And even though we got absolutely robbed on pretty much every devil deal, you know, that's what you would expect. I actually don't even it didn't even register in my brain that we didn't get that 90% one either, so unless we did and I didn't notice it, which I'm pretty sure we didn't. But at this point, I'm not even surprised. We're just, you know, that's once we missed the second 73% that we had of today, I just knew that, like, yeah, it's not gonna happen. So now it goes old Beastie for phase one. Phase two is already pretty much in the books. So thank you again, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your Friday. And let me know in the comments down below what you got planned for this weekend. I love reading all that kind of good stuff. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Steve with a Lisp, Defrain, Lasidius Dex Ludex, Nate Meldick, and Brittany Conyers. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.